Clint Parker here from the State Parkers. We are at the Sam Houston National Forest. Isn't she pretty? I'll take you over here to the registration box. We left that there for anybody coming off of the trail. It's enchiladas.
Oh wow, so there's dirt bikes, horses, humans, mountain bikes.
Alright, so we're here at the first trailhead of the 96-mile Lone Star hiking trail. But we're gonna hike until our feet fall off, so.
Woohoo! Feet falling off!
Let's see how we're packed. What you got there? Melody's got her Osprey pack, sleeping mat, pillow, water, bug spray, a lot of other goodies inside. I've got my Nestle Pure Life water. And that's it. No, I was kidding.
Packed it very heavily and very high and very cool because we're practicing right now.
Trying to use some gear that I've never used so I can learn how to sell it at my job, but also enjoy the trail and get everything for both of us.
Nice match you got there too. That looks pretty exciting. See how that works out. We've been wanting to try one of those. So I'm super stoked! Pretty cool. We have our own trail. There's our registration.
All right.
Here we go.
Trail marker number one.
Wow. So this plant right here actually helps repel against ticks and mosquitoes.
All right, so we're cruising along this trail. This is how we know where we're going. Those are the blazes. They're little metal plates that are hammered into the trees, and some of them have mile markers on them. We haven't gone into a first mile yet. We're still near the road. We're still working our way into this piece, trying to adjust to our pack weight. I'm extremely heavy.
I'm brimmed out.
She's brimmed out. And that's okay. We're gonna eat it off, drink it off, and we're gonna head into this beautiful national forest. Already looking magnificent. Feeling good. Glad to be here. Glad to be here?
Glad to be here.
First person we met on the trail.
Like it.
Officially into the wilderness. Lone Star Hiking Trail. Trail Point 1, Richards, Texas. I'm gonna be honest with you all. It took us longer to get here last night than we thought because we drove 75 freaking miles out of the way and I was misguided most terribly. So 75 miles out of the way.
I guess we got here around 5:22 in the morning.
Hikers only. We're taking a break. We've come to Forest Service Road 203, good little ways into the trail. But off to the distance, we saw this obstruction. This might hinder an emergency vehicle to get in and help someone in the case that they're injured and they need to get down this road. So we're gonna try to move it. It's pretty long, but we'll see what we can do. It looks like Melody's got it on her own. I'll come over and help you. Don't mind helping out every now and then. Clear the path. Way to go. Hopefully we find some flowing water that I can filter and drink. Ease my sorrows, ease my worries, and provide for my lovely wife. Just passed mile marker number 2, and carrying on to what's supposedly a really nice campsite.
So, with water.
With water, and if we can't find that, if we can't make it that far, which I think we can, if we don't, we're gonna cowboy it out in the woods.
Yeehaw, ticks and berries.
uprooted trees falling over. Lots of them. This one's really big. Blue skies upon us, moderately puffy clouds, no moisture threat right now, but we will see what happens. We're not prepared for rain at all. We have no rain preparation, except for my pack has a cover built into it, but that doesn't help her or me. So if it does rain, I'm thinking we just strip down, get wet, cover up our clothes as best we can. Go from there. How's it going? How far did you get in?
Hit the other loop.
Nice, nice. Okay. What do we have to look forward to? We've never been here before.
Where are you headed?
We're trying to do 16 and a half to get to the campgrounds, and I'm not.
But you're talking Stubblefield?
Maybe so. I think yeah. That's the name of
Stubblefield's
it,
yeah. At 19.
There's
some waterside camping somewhere between
Kelly,
here and there.
Kelly Pond?
Maybe.
So. Yeah. Much of the same. As far as water, I think probably about a quarter mile that way. You're gonna see a pond, but you need to have a filter for that.
I've got
Thank
it.
You.
All right, awesome.
Yeah, man.
Kelly Pond's probably your next water from there. And that's a nice place though. It's they got bathrooms, they have running water.
Yeah, that's
Oh, we can take a nice break. Okay, cool.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm Clint.
I'm Clark.
Clark? This is Melody. In about a week or so, go on YouTube, man. This will be on there. We're called the State Parkers.
Yeah. Okay.
Our last name is Parker, and we go to the state parks everywhere.
All right, awesome.
But
Apple Fish 5, so I got a show too.
Doing Sweet.
Awesome, man.
I do trail food.
Nice.
Gotta keep my girlish figure.
Cool. Well, I'll plug you.
Yeah. State Parkers, got it.
Yeah. Cool. Just sub and we'll go from there, man.
Yeah.
Radical.
Good to meet you.
Good to see you. To cross it, but it does look like that would be pretty fun to cross.
I'm ready, are you ready?
I'm ready. Okay. This where we're coming across this little water spot. It's got life forms in it. Gives us hope there might be another water source somewhere that we can relax and have some lunch. We're in the thick of it now, people. It's hot out here today, but we're in the shade for most of it. It's just heavy packs. You feeling better?
Yeah.
Feeling good? I'm loaded. She's loaded. We're gonna get on moving.
Major destruction in our way.
Tree fell right in the trail. We just had to cross over that. Not easy. We just reached the 7 mile mark. Do we look like it? Mm-hmm.
anybody know what kind of mushroom that is? We just hit the 9 mile mark. Still on day one. We're hoping that we find a water source to resupply on water somewhere pretty soon. Yeah. So it's gonna be a series of rests, walks, rests until we get there. It's a little after 4 o'clock. We started this thing at just about 12:30. We've come 9 miles and we'll keep on going. Peace. Okay, we took another break. We had to, our packs are heavy. And we are working on completing mile 10 right now. According to the documentation that I was reading and studying up on, there's a pretty good campsite around there. Our feet are killing us.
My feet are killing me.
All right, we just passed the 10 mile mark. We're at 11 miles. I see another one down here, so we'll go this way. We got a canned ham that I'm gonna cook with my MSR pocket rocket. Contained fuel stove. Lightweight, affordable. Awesome.
Feeling
rough. We gotta be getting relatively close to something. We just crossed the 12 mile marker. We had some coffee and some ibuprofen, and we're both feeling pretty good.
And lots of lucky spiders right here.
Yeah, you're not used to them because I was breaking them off already before. There's one right there. This is how we're feeling at mile 13. Okay, we've been walking through this stuff for hours. Sun is back there behind us. Going down pretty soon. We don't have a whole lot of daylight left. Melody's finding figs all over the place. At least I think that's what they are. Just crossed mile 14. We'll see. We found a sign that said Kelly Pond Campground. We're on our way to that. It said it was only a mile, so we're trucking up this road to go try to find our way into that thing so we can resupply, get some rest. Alright.
It's been beautiful.
Not a bad first day. Yeah, we did pretty good today. Our feet hurt. We're in a tent. We met some fellow campers that may or may not give us a lift to our car in the morning so we don't have to walk 16 miles back. Melody's eating ham. Ham from our pocket rocket stove. Hey, State Parkers here. Trail magic happened to us once again. We camped there last night, but we had to walk about 16 miles in. And then we met up with these nice folks last night that hooked us up with some fresh water so we didn't have to do too much filtering. And now, since the stars align, we managed to get a ride back to our car. So, woohoo! Let me say thank you to, say your name.
Rafael.
Melody. And his ladies back at keeping their tent warm for them so he can take us to our car. So, you never know what's gonna happen out here on the trail. Sam Houston National Forest, everybody.
We found something really fun. Bluebell Creameries. This is the factory where the best ice cream in the country is manufactured.
Okay, well, that's the courtyard at the Bluebell Creameries. That's where they make the bluebells. Best ice cream in the country.
That was awesome. Thank you for your ice cream.
Bluebell, best ice cream in the country.